Hey everyone, I'm Diego Viteri. Welcome to a new video of Viteri Boxing. Today I'm going to show you the art of deception, which is the key so you can never ever miss a punch. So let's begin. When we are fighting, everything's about a psychological warfare. There are small movements that create something from your opponent or yourself so you can do something about it. Most of the times we use two things to deceive our opponent: feinting and baiting. But most people are confused with the definitions and think they're the same. Feinting is when you do small movements and you make your opponent do an error. He opens a space and you can land a punch. Or maybe you can use feinting as a way to know how your opponent reacts or how your opponent likes to fight. And that way you can have better strategies and tactics to win over your opponent. Baiting is different because in this way you don't make your opponent do a mistake. You do a mistake on purpose. Maybe you drop your arm on purpose to make him believe you did a mistake. He throws a punch, it's easy to slip, and then you counter. Or maybe the one that Floyd Mayweather uses, the one that he goes with his head, he pretends he's with his guard down, he pulls back, and then he counters. That's also another way of baiting. So the main difference about feinting and baiting is that feinting is when you make your opponent do a mistake, and baiting is when you do a mistake on purpose to make your opponent believe. It's everything about a psychological warfare. So the drill number one that you're going to work at home is to always include feinting in your combinations. If you're going to throw a 1-2-3, a normal 1-2-3, make sure to work the same combinations but with a feint. Maybe throw the jab, then when you're throwing the cross, you just feint, and then you throw the hook. So you go, jab, feint, hook. Jab, feint, hook. And you move, jab, feint, hook. If you want another combination that you can use, maybe you can throw the jab, then you move, you feint the jab, and then you throw the 1-2. You move, you throw the jab, you move, feint, 1-2. So always try to include feinting your combinations. It will break the rhythm of your opponent, and he's going to try to think what punch is real, what punch is not real. So he's going to make a lot of mistakes, and it's going to be easier for you to land a lot more punches. Another way that you can make your opponent throw a punch so you can never miss the punch you want to throw is to lure your opponent. When you lure your opponent or probe your opponent, basically is to throw a flicker jab. Don't put too much weight into your punch. Just leave your arm really relaxed. Just touch your opponent, probe him. And using the double end bag is perfect because you're going to receive something in return. You can slip, you can look for angles, and you can counter. So basically you're going to work with the flicker jab, slip and counter, slip and counter, slip and counter. You're going to work with the double end bag, slipping and countering. After you have worked with the double end bag, slipping and countering, you can work also by luring your opponent or probing and using his punch to get to a better angle. So not everything has to be about countering your opponent. Sometimes you want his punch to help you get to a better angle. One is to counter. The other is you can slip and you can move to another angle. You move to another way. If you want to go to the other side, the same thing. You slip and you move to the other side and you can punch from another angle. Those things, countering your opponent, probing your opponent, and going to another angle are the main factors that are going to help you to always connect your opponent, and he can't connect you. That's the whole point of human chess. And what I like about the double end bag is that you have to show your real boxing. In here, it doesn't matter how hard you punch. It's all about the way you box. If you know how to block, if you know how to slip, if you know how to create angles. So here you will show your real boxing. So I would recommend you to buy this and start working with the double end bag. To work on baiting, as you have to make an error on purpose to make your opponent believe he has an opportunity, you can't work that on the punching bag or the double end bag. You have to work with a partner. So I will always recommend to do technical sparring, to work on different kind of setting traps, setting with your creating an illusion going forward, dropping a hand here, maybe opening space on your ribs, and make your opponent believe he has an opportunity. Whenever he throws, you just counter your opponent. Those ways, you're never gonna miss a punch because you can always anticipate of what he's gonna do. The whole point of human chess is to show your opponent you are better by technique, not by brute force. You don't have to take his head off. You have to always win by technique. So whenever you are training with someone, the whole point is to work on everything you've been doing the whole week or the whole month or whole year. You've been working on baiting, and the whole satisfaction is whenever your opponent falls on that exactly technique you were working so much. That's a satisfaction. You're never gonna have satisfaction of breaking opponent's nose, opponent's face. So the whole point of human chess is to master the craft, master your body, master your mind, and to know exactly how the movement works. So it's gonna be little by little, but you are gonna completely master the craft if you put the dedication and work into it. I'll see you next week for the next class.